स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम बैक टू बॉस्को कैंपस विजन यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ कोट्टयम डॉन बॉस्को कॉलेज। आई एम रानियार, फैकल्टी मेंबर ऑफ पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश। दिस टाइम आई एम हियर विद द पेपर मेथडोलॉजी एंड पर्सपेक्टिव्स ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटीज विच इज द कोर पेपर फॉर सिक्स सेमेस्टर बीए इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड लिटरेचर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ केरला यूनिवर्सिटी। एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द सीरीज। इन दिस सीरीज we are discussing an introduction to the paper methodology and perspectives of humanities. So before that, let's check the syllabus of the paper. This paper methodology and perspectives of humanities has three modules. So before that, I would like to remind you one thing. There is a prescribed core textbook is given for this paper, and the name of the paper is Humanities Methodology and Perspectives, and which is edited by Dr. K. Kamala. So as I mentioned, this paper constitutes three modules. The first module discusses humanities differences between natural, social and human sciences, facts and interpretation, history and fiction, objectivity versus subjectivity. Second module discusses a critical overview of literature from the perspectives of humanities. In addition to that, impact of society on literature, text types, genres, literary canon, literary interpretation and evaluation. And the last module discusses certain literary terms, then text-oriented approaches, philology, rhetoric, stylistics, new criticism, semiotics and ambiguity. So this is the syllabus of the paper Methodology and Perspectives of Humanities. So my dear students, I hope you understood the syllabus of the paper. So let's begin the first lecture of the paper Humanities. As we all know, our forefathers, that means primitive people, they lived in forests. At that time they struggled a lot with the hostile conditions, hostile forces around them. They were in need of food, clothes and shelter. At that time, they make tools from rocks. So in order to defend the adverse situations around him and to move forward, they find shelter from nature. So every man lived in close communion with nature at that time. And what is the situation now? We lost our close contact with nature. And the one thing it is clear that nothing in this world stands in isolation. All are interdependent. Here lies the significance or the need of the relationship, mutual relationship with man and nature. So it is very essential. Once an anthropologist who conducted a research, and as part of that research he made an experiment. He called a group of children. He told a group of children that he had kept a basket full of sweets under a tree. The one to touch the basket first would get all the sweets. He signaled to provoke them to run and compete for the sweets. And to his wonder, the children ran hand in hand and all of them reached together. To the astounded experimenter, the children disclosed that they wanted everybody to share whatever gains they reaped. So it was no pleasure for one child to snatch the whole thing. Each one of them believed that he existed because of others. Here actually lies the significance of Ubuntu. Ubuntu philosophy, hope you heard the term Ubuntu. The term Ubuntu means humanity. It is translated as I am because we are. So I am existed because of others. Okay, so nothing in this world stands in isolation. All are interdependent. human beings, other living things, non-living things, etc. So the whole ecosystem remain as one single unit. And this is the truth advocated by all subjects of humanities and all sciences should stands for this comprehension. This interrelatedness of existence is not acknowledged by all. That is why here in our society there exists oppression, torture and subjugation. In our society we can see various forms of oppression, torture, etc. There is a poem is provided in your textbook under the title What Would You Do? This poem explains the anguish faced by Dalit community in the face of discrimination on the basis of their caste and birth. So my dear students, please go through the poem, read the poem 2 or 3 times. When we consider another situation, I hope you remember the Nobel Prize acceptance speech of Martin Luther King Jr. He begins his speech like this: I accept the Nobel Prize for Peace at a moment when 22 million Negroes of the United States of America are engaged in a creative battle to end the long night of racial injustice. So, why this happened? Why this discrimination happens? If everyone are ready to accept others' rights, is there any need? Is there any question arise in the name of injustice? Never. So when someone denies or not ready to accept other people's right, then only there comes oppression or subjugation, anything like that. So from the speech of Martin Luther King Jr., it is very evident that he is mentioning the struggle against the denial of basic civil rights to his fellow black people. And there is another story is provided in your textbook, and the story is titled Right Fig. It is written by Kate Chopin. In this short story, we can observe the intimacy of characters, especially Maman Nainan and Babette. They share a communion with nature. The story glorifies how ecology is a part of literature, marking its importance in humanities. So, humanities is such a kind of a discipline in which all subjects or all different streams are associated with humanities. So, it discusses something related to humanity or human beliefs, values, etc. And another poem is referred in this particular textbook. Through the poem titled Andrea del Sarto, the Victorian poet Robert Browning studies human mind. From all these examples, we can understand that humanities has relation with all other streams of life. Okay, my dear students, with this I am concluding for today. Let's take the rest of the portions in our coming classes. I'd like to remind you one thing. Please do the homework and send me through WhatsApp. Then only you'll get attendance. Thank you. Have a nice day.